Why was Bard banned? And why do I think it's fine now? Let's discuss that real quick on Mobile Monday. Bard is honestly one of my favorite cards in the game. Just the sheer power it demonstrates is amazing while still technically being fair. The reason why it was even banned in the first place was because Orcus was such a powerhouse and because Bard was so good in Orcus. But now that Orcus isn't nearly as relevant, it's not nearly as prevalent, especially when we have other cards in the game like Hauk into Auroradon, Bard seems a lot more fair setting up two Fog Blades comparatively to what we have now. Back in its heyday, Bard was played in two specific strategies, one being Goki, Rongo, Nimiad because of the fact that Bard enabled the missing pieces to get to your XYZ plays, and in Orcus just because it did so much for the theme because Orcus needed something to link climb into, and Bard fit that role perfectly. But now with Orcus severely nerfed comparatively to its former tier 1 self, Bard was able to come back, and in today's metagame with not as much being able to abuse it, or just the non-necessity of Bard in any deck, it just becomes that much better. Let me give you an example here. Bard could easily be played in Dragon Link, but why is it not being played? Because you don't really need it. Additionally, you don't really want to be playing the Phantom Knights and the Fog Blades and everything because it's unsynergistic with your strategy. Even in a deck like Infernoble, sure, you can make Bard, but what's the point in doing so when you can just do other potentially more powerful plays? The current main deck to utilize Bard in is Goki, but even then, that deck is just not as competent as the rest of the meta. So overall, Bard was banned because it was just too good in specific strategies. However, with the lack of strategies that can abuse Bard as well, additionally with so many more options now than what we had back when Bard was in its prime, I think it's safe to say it's great to have you back, Bard.